I think he just ate the jellyfish.
He ate that jellyfish. He sure did.
Hey, what's up, YouTube? Okay, so today I'm running out to meet Brant at the marina, and we're gonna do a Catch and Cook Sabiki challenge. Me, Gregg, and Brant over there at Angler Up, Gregg Ammon Outdoors, and then we're gonna take it home and eat it. This is gonna be wild. So I'll see you when we get to the boat ramp. All right, so this is gonna be a wild adventure. Of course, you know, when you get all three of us together, it's gonna be a wild adventure. Anything can happen. Just pulled up at the Bayou Chico Marina. Say that three times fast. All right, here we are. There's Gregg.
Heyo.
Okay, today we are gonna do the Sabiki rig challenge that everybody has been asking about.
Woo!
Stay tuned.
All right, so I'm a little nervous about this this challenge. I've never eaten a blue runner, a hardtail, a sardine, or a, he's making fun of me up here, or a, any of those. This is gonna be awful. Also, life goal right here.
Y'all ready to roll?
Here he comes. Here he comes, the captain.
I got two kayakers going with me today, so who knows what's gonna happen.
Hope we don't get sick.
Here we go! There's a good one. Woo! Oh, that'll ring your back.
I think it's the biggest turtle I've ever seen.
Yeah, that thing's gotta be 100 years old.
Oh, look at that. Oh my God, look at that.
Check this thing out. He's got something on his back.
That's one of the biggest turtles I've ever seen. It's a big leatherback.
That thing is huge. Holy, I think he just ate the jellyfish.
That jellyfish. He sure did.
Straight. He's going under the boat. That is the biggest turtle I've ever seen in my entire life. He is absolutely ginormous. All right, so if you look over my shoulder here, I don't know if you can see, but there's a jet ski dude out here. See him right there? See the jet ski guy right here? He's out here trolling around with the jet ski fishing. He's doing real guy stuff out here. What's up, man? He's out here trolling some dusters around the wreck, around the buoys, doing some real guy stuff. All right, so I lost my hat on the way out. So if anybody finds a Yak Motley hat back there, let me know, because it's gone. It was rough. Also, that was the biggest turtle I've ever seen in my entire life. I've already said that like five times. I'm just saying it again, because that was serious. Brant concurs, so does Gregg. He had to have been like a 100-year-old, 200-year-old turtle.
He was at least a 6-foot long turtle.
Yeah, he was like at least 6 foot long. I don't know if you can see it in the camera. Like a big, long, dark spot.
Looks like there would be a cloud overhead, but there's no clouds.
Yeah, it looks like there's a cloud on the water, but there's no clouds. Check it out. Oh, is that like the stack or something right there? Check this out.
That's why you gotta be really careful.
I don't know if you can see it, that white right there is actually the top of this ship, it's a smokestack. We're doing right now is right here in the pass, just past the pass, and we are sabikiing this little wreck out here. And Brant just got a cigar minnow. Looks like he's eating it. So I gotta get mine finished. I got my sabiki right here, and I gotta get it finished and get it out there.
I got a whole stringer coming up here, boys. Oh, it came off.
Oh, looks like you're eating cigar minnows.
Cigar minnow. I had like three coming up. Got off right there. All right, I got a cigar, but he's going in the cooler.
We'll try the outside edge. There's one. I think I got a cig.
All right, Jack's got to catch one now.
I got something on here.
Jack's hooked
I
up.
Got something. Oh, I got some. Oh, it's a cigar minnow.
All right, let's do
it. We got three cigs in there. Gregg just caught a Speedo. Baby mackerel, some or another.
Here now. What are we working with?
I don't know. I think it doesn't feel like a cigar minnow, but It's a cigar minnow.
Throw him in the live well. We'll go try to catch.
This one's got a king on him. I can smell it.
Looks like a king.
Oh,
an LY.
LY, yeah.
All right, update. The Thunderbirds are flying over, giving us an awesome air show. Saw the Blue Angels. Gregg's in the lead, what, with three species?
Two.
No. Two? Brant? We're all tied. Y'all are tied. I only got one species. And if you're wondering why I don't have a hat on, it's because it blew off earlier. Yeah, that kind of happened. It was a wild episode. Lost my GoPro. Everything went that way. You got one? False alarm, cigar minnow. All right, Brant's got a big old fish on.
We're sitting here doing the Sabiki challenge, so I decided to flip a bait out the back. Just while we're sitting here, and the second it hits the water, it gets hammered. I mean hammered. So we'll see what it is.
I was over here all content with my little cigar minnow, and then his reel starts screaming. Mix the air show. Check out the air show. Brant's hooked up to a big fish.
I just had my rod rigged up from this morning's charter. Giant. Man. We can net them. Hooked right in the belly. That's a big weird. Spanish, though.
That's a big Spanish. That is a huge Spanish, dude. Brant just caught a foul-hooked monster Spanish. This is a beast. This is a flat-out beast.
Right here, Jack. That's a good Spanish right there. Whoa! Almost got mackerel slapped. That's a big Spanish. I literally just threw out a bait just while we're sitting here just to have a bait out. Man, he hammered it.
All these cigar minnows we were catching, we threw one back there just for safekeeping. Always gotta have a troll line out. And that's what it rendered. That big old Spanish mackerel, which is now in the cooler, that is a stud bruiser. All right.
All right, Gregg, show me the skills. Whoa!
Gregg's hooked up. Was it a Spanish or is it a...
Yeah, probably. It doesn't feel that big.
Got a taco.
Yep.
A serious taco.
They make good grilled fish on top of salads.
There he is out there. That is one huge Spanish. It's my hand. There's a Spanish.
Maybe there'll be a big king in here too.
Oh, those are some chompers right there.
Oh, I got now he's on. Get him.
That's a Spanish. All right. Next, got one. They're hitting it the second it hits the water out here.
Awesome. Look at that.
Awesome, baby.
That's a professional cameraman right there.
That's a stud.
One hand on the camera, one hand on the net.
There we go.
Woo!
Alright guys, so our Sabiki challenge turned into a bunch of Spanish mackerel. Check out these jets, man. They're everywhere.
That's pretty cool right there. Here they are. Oh! Ha 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 ha! Tie ball game, baby. Woo! Look at that. Look at those little stripes, those waves on his back. Hey, so is Brant behind now? Woo, Branson! He's behind now. I told you it's gonna be the greatest comeback in history.
Boom! I just tied the ball game.
Ah!
I just tied the ball game with a hardtail.
Bang! All right, so Brant just tied it up and got a hardtail. Oh. Now I need a hardtail for the win. Pinfish!
Yeah, I got a pinfish!
America! From behind right there, I got a pinfish. Come from behind.
Fish.
Look at look that. Don't count me out, baby. Don't count me out.
He's been
in the
he's
cooler.
Been talking about all day how he wanted to eat a pinfish. Want to eat a pinfish. Well, now he's going to get his chance.
It's going to happen, baby. Oh. Gregg's got a hardtail in the thumb. Sabiki in the hand. Hardtail in the boat.
Check it. There he is. Okay, we gotta get back to the Sabiki challenge, but I just want to update you. We got three stud Spanish mackerel, and the Thunderbirds are awesome. They're not quite as good as the Blue Angels, but they're awesome. So we're at the USS Massachusetts out here, and you can see the smokestack pretty much cresting out of the water.
25 yards away from
see it right there? That is like the smokestack. Right now, was it Gregg's in the lead?
Nope. Me and Gregg and I are tied.
Gregg and Brant are tied for the lead. I'm in last place with a Cigar Minnow and an LY. They got Speedos and a Cigar Minnow and what?
An LY.
Yes, so they're ahead. So right now,
we got a Northern, a Cigar Minnow, and an LY.
Yep, that's what they got. And I am gonna make the greatest come from behind victory ever. I'm gonna get me a Pinfish. It's gonna be a bruiser. And then maybe one of them little spotted Pinfish, whatever they call them things.
All right,
and,
got some Pinfish down
there. I'm gonna do it! I'm gonna do it, everybody! Going to the next spot. They're ahead of me with a blue runner. I'm really thinking I was gonna get one, but I didn't. It's coming down to the wire. I need a croaker or maybe a pigfish. I got the one pinfish out there, and they got the blue runners. I was in the lead. They came
Hardtails.
Back.
Hardtail blue runners.
They're the same thing.
Oh, are they?
Yeah, blue
runners. Oh, yeah, whatever.
All right, so it's 4-4-4. It's all tied up. They need a pinfish, and I need some kind of something other than the pinfish. So the game's in their ballpark.
Jack's got a pinfish.
Ah!
You're saying there's a chance. Jack's got a pinfish. Jack is the pinfish man. Look at all the men hating under the boat, guys. There's tons of fogies. I do not want to catch one of those because I don't want to have to eat a men hating. I'm not eating a pinfish unless I catch it.
So I thought I had the breaker.
Right, let's go.
Wound up being another pinfish.
Game over.
It's a cigar minnow.
Game over.
Oh.
Look at this, we're right, literally right at the entrance, right here of the marina. I mean, we're making it to the house. I said one last cast and I caught a pinfish.
Oh no, and I got tangled up. It's over for me.
The challenge is over.
It's over. Brant wins.
That's how it's done right there, boy.
Close, but no cigar. All right, guys, so this is the next day. We had to put them on the cooler on ice, and I'm over here at the Angler Up compound, fixing to go in here, and we're gonna cook these. We got cigar minnows, pinfish, like LYs. I think we got a menhaden, and yeah, blue runners, hardtails. So we're gonna go in here and cook them. So here we go. So come on, let's go cook these fish. So it's like 10:30. I don't know if I'm feeling LYs for breakfast. That's the Spanish mackerel from yesterday.
A northern, a cigar minnow, and a pinfish. Oh yeah, look at that. Look at that. So we're gonna take his guts out.
Some fine protein right there.
Oh yeah, we're gonna take his guts out there. And I'm just gonna kind of get, he doesn't really have many scales, but they do have very tiny scales. So I'm gonna get these little scales off here. It's like sardines, baby. Did y'all, anybody grow up eating sardines? We're gonna cook him whole.
We're about to pan fry and cook these little fish. And they remind me just like a sardine. And so basically, I mean, we all ate sardines. I love sardines. I still eat sardines. So like most of these look just like a sardine. Once you, we just basically like gutted them and got the scales off of them. And it they're actually turning out to be something that you would probably actually eat. Anything smaller than a frying pan is usually the best to eat. These are just a little smaller. But this challenge has been a lot of fun, and it has totally been way different than anything we've done in the past. And I think that's what made it so much fun.
So we've got our fish right here. What we're gonna do now is season them. Now we're gonna do this very simple. We've got five fish, and we're gonna just season them with salt and pepper. We're gonna pan fry them in olive oil, and then we're gonna squeeze some lemon juice over the top of them when we're done. So we're just gonna season them pretty heavily with sea salt here, and then we're gonna pepper them. Got our hardtail, our LY, our pinfish, our cigar minnow, and our northern mackerel. So now we are ready to throw these bad boys in the skillet. All right, here goes nothing. Let's go with the northern mackerel first, right here.
Woo!
Yeah. Now the cigar minnow. Now the pinfish. Mr. L.Y., aka Pilchard, will end the day with the hardtail.
We're definitely here to educate and motivate, because I think this dog, this is good. I think it's going to be surprisingly decent. I think, and there's going to be a lot of trolls on this, I can guarantee you, but it's going to be decent. It's looking good. It smells decent, doesn't smell terrible, and I think it's going to surprise a few people.
Shaky.
Right now, I think the hardtail is looking a little shaky because the bloodline's still in it. Aren't they in the Jack family?
Yeah, we should have taken the bloodline out of the hardtail. But again, I mean, it's a small fish, so the bloodline doesn't mean as much. I mean, the fish is this long, so it doesn't mean as much.
Yeah, by the time we got the bloodline out, we'd have like this much meat for us three big burly dudes. So, like, I think we're just winging it.
We're just cooking it whole and rolling with it here.
Doesn't smell bad.
All right, dudes, so we are ready to chow down. This is the end of the Sabiki Rig Challenge. You saw us out in the boat. We ended up catching five species. So we've got a hardtail, a cigar minnow, a northern, a pilchard, L.Y., whatever you wanna call it, and a pinfish. So we're gonna start right now. Each of us are gonna take a bite of a different species. Gonna give our opinion, and we're gonna see what happens. This should be pretty interesting. What do y'all think?
It's gonna be wild.
So we're gonna start off with the pinfish. This Jack's been excited to eat a pinfish. I'm gonna let Jack.
I've been waiting for this one because I think they're gonna taste just like a brown.
Go for it, dude. Go for it.
Still got its skin on though.
Not my favorite. It was kind of strong. Just really didn't have a great flavor.
Full of bones.
Pepper got me.
Jack's choking. All right, so right now, I'm
kinda
not...
plain.
Yeah, the pinfish just didn't really that great.
It's an eh.
Rank these from 1 to 5. So pinfish first. We'll see what happens once we finish the other. Next, we're going to do the pilchard L.Y.
Doing the L.Y. now.
Wow. Dude, that's awesome. I'm not even kidding. That's better than sardines.
I ain't got a piece left. We got to flip him over.
Flip him over. Dude, that is really good.
Oh, wow.
Really good.
Bones aren't, it's not, the bones stay on the on the actual skeleton, not in the meat.
I'm very, very, I like the skin too. I'm very happy with the L.Y.
Yeah.
What do you think, Gregg?
I'm impressed.
Man, really? I'm telling you.
Way better than the pinfish, way better.
Do we got any more of those in there?
It's hard, man, I actually would cook that again. Love the L.Y. I got a bone.
Yeah, if you had like 20 of these bad boys,
man, that is, you'd be good. That was really, really good. I'm impressed. Let's go with the northern mackerel, the little northern here.
I think this one's gonna be good. All right, you can go, Gregg.
That's in second place so far to the L.Y. Not bad, not great. I probably wouldn't have it again. I don't know. I mean, it's okay.
Yeah, it's good too.
It's not bad.
Tastes like a sardine.
Yeah.
Yeah, like a can of sardines.
Let me explain. The L.Y. was exceptional, and the northern's just like a sardine. It's not bad. The pinfish is trash.
The pinfish, was not good.
Cigar minnow. Now, we know how much these big fish like mackerel and stuff love these. So everything eats a cigar minnow. Yeah. There's got to be a reason.
There's got to be a reason why everything eats these guys.
Cigar minnow. I got a bone.
Good, Jack.
Man, that's nice.
There's a reason why, huh?
That's not bad, man. It's very mild. Lot of flavor. Mild, but it's not a fishy flavor. It's just like a sweet meat, man.
I think that's number two.
That's number two for sure. Not as good as the L.Y. I'll actually eat another piece of the L.Y. right now, man. I would go catch a bunch of these to eat them.
Yeah, L.Y. is, in my opinion, the best so far, the L.Y.
I don't know.
I'm not a fan of the cigars. Cigar,
yeah.
Maybe I just got a limiting spot. All right.
I'm getting bones.
Yep. They're bony. That's the bad problem. These are small fish. They're bony.
You gotta cook them.
I got
longer.
One sitting right back.
But we the sardine.
Cook them longer.
Or the L.Y. The bones just stuck to the skeleton.
Right.
I didn't have any problems.
Here's the piece de resistance.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, dudes. It's time for the hardtail, the big fish,
kind of in the Jack family.
You're going for the bloodline.
Yeah, we're gonna have to get out of that.
We're gonna have to eat out of the, eat around the bloodline. All right. Around it.
Okay, here goes the hardtail. I don't hate it. It's a little strong. I mean, it's, man, it's not that bad. Dude.
No, not that bad. Not nearly as tangy as that one. Not nearly as that one. Let's see if I can get another piece.
No, that's actually,
I'm gonna get a
tasty
piece of the bloodline. I'm getting a piece of the bloodline, the hardtail.
That's actually pretty tasty.
Yeah, the hardtail's pretty tasty. It's not bad.
Better than tilapia.
All right, here, let's rank them from 1 to 5. I'm gonna say for sure we both all agree that LY's number one.
Yeah.
Yep. I actually am going to go with, what do y'all think? It's tough, man. The Northern, the Hardtail, and the Cigar Minnow are kind of similar.
Yeah. I like the Northern better than the Cigar Minnow, and the Hardtail was better than the Cigar Minnow. And the Pinfish is dead last. That
Pinfish
one, that one
awful.
Can be concurred.
Pinfish is dead last. I'm going LY, Northern, Hardtail, Cigar Minnow, and Pinfish.
Yeah, that sounds good. I can go with that.
Say it again.
I would. I'm gonna go with LY, Northern, Hardtail, Cigar Minnow, and Pinfish.
Yeah, it's
maybe. I don't know.
I'm gonna go. The LY, the Hardtail, cigar, the Northern, and
yeah,
the Pinfish.
Okay. Yeah, that's. I mean, either way, it's. Yeah.
Yeah, I like the Northern better than Cigar Minnow. Maybe I got a bad piece, but the Hardtail was.
So guys, let me explain here. In a lot of different,
flip it over and get another big piece.
Yeah. Jump on a little more of the hardtail.
Get some of that back meat there. A little bit of blood.
A guy at the dock actually, as we were pulling in yesterday, said that he eats these hardtails.
Yeah.
They eat blue runners a lot. So we thought we had something going on there.
Especially if you get the bigger, because I've caught them before where they were, you know, like yay big.
Yeah.
Those would probably be good.
So, I mean, our conclusion is that you can eat anything that swims in the ocean just about. Now, I don't recommend pinfish at all, but man, these other, I would actually go out and clean a bunch of these LYs and pan fry them like that. I thought that was good. I thought that was really, really good. Man, it, you know, I was surprised. It tasted better than sardines in a can. A lot fresher,
yeah,
but kind of similar, but just way fresher. And you know, anytime you're eating small fish like this, like the pilchards or the sardines, man, they're going to be way healthier than these big fish that most people eat, because I mean they're going to be lower in heavy metals and higher in omega-3s and all kind of stuff like that. So you're really getting a lot more out of eating these small fish. We had a good time doing the doing this challenge. It was definitely different. What do y'all think?
Yeah, I had a lot of fun. I realized that fishing boils down to the people you're with, and just relaxing and having fun. It's not about always catching the most whopping fish out there, because if you do that alone, nobody sees it, and you've got nobody to experience it with. Well, you can catch little fish and still have fun.
Look what we did yesterday, though. We spent 2 hours out at the USS Massachusetts. We caught probably 100 or so bait fish. We watched the Thunderbirds fly overhead.
Yeah, it was
a great
Thunderbirds
day.
Were doing a practice
saw
out of
a giant
Pensacola.
Turtle, Jack.
The most hugest turtle I've ever seen in my entire life.
The biggest leatherback turtle I've ever seen
this
in my life.
This thing was like three of these tables. Like, it was, I mean, the head on this thing was this big.
I was
big
just
around.
Upset there weren't any cobias with it.
It had some remoras on it, not to mention throwing some of these cigar minnows back out, and we were catching
big
Spanish. Caught some of the biggest Spanish mackerel I've ever seen. I was cleaning them on my tailgate this morning, and the biggest one was like 29 and a half inches, and the smallest one was almost 24 inches.
Yeah, they were gigantic.
So I've
gigantic.
Got more Spanish mackerel in my freezer right now that I know what to do with.
Yeah.
So guys, that's a wrap. The Sabiki Rig Challenge.
I think that's good.
All right, so we just finished it.
Yeah,
and
there's nothing left of that LY.
We totally stripped these fish. Like, the hardtail was actually pretty good. And as you saw, like, we ranked them probably the best we could. And pinfish came in last. But I've realized after eating all these fish, people say you can't eat most of this fish all taste the same. It's all in the cook and the batterer and all that stuff. So Brant's up here getting weird with them, but Yeah, guys, like if it's a clean fish and other things are eating it, most likely you can eat it. And if I was starving, I would eat all these over one of those tilapia that come from a foreign country that grows up in a fish tank. So that's all I got, guys. I hope, please like and subscribe. Follow me on Instagram at Yak Motley, Brant on Angler Up, and Gregg at Gregg Ammons Outdoors. And check out their YouTube channels. They'll be in the links below, and I'll see you guys later.